Hi guys, welcome back. Today's video is going to be a little different. I am going to go to the office and ask Matt some of the questions that we've gotten on our YouTube channel. Since I'm not the technician, but I run the YouTube channel, I'm not the best one to answer them. So let's head over. Hey, I have a bunch of comments on our YouTube channel that I need an expert to answer. Let's start with, it's about our video that we just did about trade school versus apprenticeship program.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And James Walker asks this question, a retired HVAC tech informed me that going straight into the field instead of completing trade school is a disadvantage because a certificate will earn a higher rate of pay and also allow you entry into a labor union. Is any of that true, or is it outdated information?
I think it depends on your path and where you want to go. If you're interested in getting into a labor union, it probably would be better to pursue the trade school route. I don't know, and I can't say with confidence that there are locations out there that are union shops that don't have an apprentice program. There very well may be. But I would say that certifications and diplomas and degrees and stuff like that, can it increase your pay? Can it give you more income? I would say, my opinion, no. It might make you more employable. They might feel more inclined to give you a shot because you've already been through trade school and you've already pursued that avenue. But in most cases, depending on the shop, they can do all of the education themselves and teach you the same thing the trade schools are teaching. But I would say that if you're interested in getting into the union, a lot of union shops are commercial and industrial applications for heating and air conditioning. That's probably a situation where you may want to pursue trade school.
But don't you think if he really wants to be in a union, he should maybe ask questions about, find out what that particular union's requirements are, and then go check all those boxes,
right? Like, yep, call them, go talk to them in person.
See what they need before you go and do something, and then they say, oh, you didn't need that after all.
Exactly, good point.
Okay, another question from Queen L. Kelly. My central air blows very cold air in the morning, mm-hmm. late evenings and nights, yet a couple of hours past noon, AC air becomes cool with a slightly warm flow until outside temperatures drop for that evening. This 410 unit has a new compressor, motor, capacitor, connector, freon, a fairly new 1.5 month filter. Also, the unit coils were rinsed off several times, but no improvement. What could be the problem, please? Thank you so much.
Good question. I would say that the air coming out of the vents should be a definite split between the air temperatures in the house and the air coming out of the vents. That should not change in the middle of the day. If the air coming out of the vents is actually changing, if it is actually getting warmer out of the vents and it's not as cold as it was before, then something is definitely not right. And it needs to, the performance of the air conditioner is not working properly. If an air conditioner is undersized, it'll still have that cold air coming out of the vents. It'll still be the same cold air, the same temperature of air potentially as it was in the middle of the night, but it's not keeping up. But if the actual temperature of the air coming out of the vents is increasing, then that's a performance problem. Something's not working properly.
Okay, we've had a couple of videos about our UV lights, and are these UV lights installed inside the AC ducts?
They are, yeah. Those UV lights have to be installed inside a contained space. So inside, because you're not supposed to be looking at them. So they're inside of ductwork. They're contained by sheet metal. They're surrounded by ductwork. You know, I think another question that somebody had asked was,
Does it matter if you have flex duct or sheet metal duct systems?
Yep. It's ideal to have sheet metal duct systems. You do not want UV light to be in direct contact with flexible ductwork. Flexible ductwork is lined on the inside with a plastic lining with a coil inside of it, a metal coil. The metal coil is not the problem, but the plastic lining is. And sunlight, just like if I set a plastic cup out on a picnic table in the sun and left it there for a week, that cup would be degrading, be faded, the plastic would be getting brittle and broken down. And if you put a UV light in direct contact, it's shining sunlight on plastic, it will destroy it. It'll disintegrate. Now, it can be flex duct, like down the path, that's fine, but just in the direct sunlight path, it's gotta be metal.
Okay. Does the UV light run all the time? I thought it works with the blower. Would that be a waste when your system is idle?
Yes, that's a good question. And UV light, like we talked about in that video, is concerned about dwell time.
It's when it comes to UVC energy killing germs, viruses, and bacteria, we call it dwell time. So it's all a matter of how long is that spore dwelling on that bulb? How long is it exposed to the bulb? Because the longer it's exposed to the bulb, the higher likelihood that we have a kill rate. When we put in UV systems, we help coach our homeowners on blower. How long is the blower running? How slow is the fan running? The slower the fan, the higher kill rate, because it's right. The air is moving slower. Therefore, a virus that's airborne is also moving slower across that light.
It needs that air movement to continue causing that dwell time over and over and over again. Whereas, if the UV light is running all the time and you're not running the blower, it's not really doing its job. It's not doing its thing.
And then just one more, what's the specific name and model of the UV light in your video?
We use an OxyQuantum LED. It is a very, very strong, very high quality light.
Thanks for answering these questions for
me. You're welcome.